I humbly accept my party's nomination to be Vice President of the United States.
Day three of the Democratic National Convention wrapped up. Tonight's lineup included President Obama, Vice President Biden, and as you just heard, Vice Presidential nominee Tim Kaine, as he accepts his role as the Vice Presidential nominee for the Democratic Party. On the heels of a historic night, Hillary Clinton, now the first woman nominated for president by a major party. And despite your party preference, this milestone even more surprising for those living when women didn't even have the right to vote. Local 2's John Logg brings us more with a 93-year-old Midland woman who says she never thought she'd see the day.
But that's the privilege that we have now. Even though I'm not for Hillary, it's still the privilege of going and voting.
A privileged Midland resident, Ella Heath, says she takes advantage of this day and age after the 19th Amendment granted women the right to vote in 1920, just 3 years before she was born.
Of course, back in my days, it was different, darling.
Different in the sense that women didn't run for office or think of contributing to politics.
You wouldn't see female doing anything other than keeping house, working, taking care of children. That's what they did.
And if she was asked back then if a woman would ever run for president,
I'd say you must be crazy. I wouldn't even have thought about it because I didn't even think about things like that.
Professors here at UTPB agree that whether you support Clinton or not, this moment will be marked in history.
And the idea that in many states women couldn't even vote for president, and now we finally have a candidate from a major party who's been nominated, it's obviously a very historic moment, irrespective of whether she wins or loses.
A moment Heath didn't know she'd ever see, but is now living.
We didn't do things like they do now. It wasn't even expected.
Don Logg, Local 2 News.